What do we mean by instinct, impulse, and intelligence? First, these three things. So, instinct is basically a bodily response for self-preservation. All living beings have instincts. So, if I touch my hand over here and say by chance there's electricity over here, I feel a current, I'll move my hand away. If I feel hot, I'll move my hand away. So, in these cases, in the case of instinct, we don't think, just act. And this sort of action is actually good. It's a bodily response for our protection. At the same time, so there are some situations in which we unthinkingly act right. A body is prompted or programmed to act in the right way for protecting itself. But there are other situations where we unthinkingly act wrong. So for example here, when we get the second example, I'll give in both ways. So when we smell food, immediately we salivate. That's just the body's mechanism by which the digestive fluids are generated, and then we can digest the food properly. But the impulse is more of the mind's pushing us towards things it thinks are enjoyable. There also, when we act impulsively, there is not much thinking that is done. An alcoholic, as soon as the alcoholic sees a bar or a bottle, immediately undrinks. So here, it's not needed for survival, but it's just automatically done. And based on the kind of life we have lived, all of us will have different impulses. So in both, the commonality in instinct and impulses that we act without thinking. But instincts are often protective and necessary for the body. Whereas impulses are often counterproductive. They're just, the mind, I have to do this, I do it, and then it turns out not so good. Now, at one level, intelligence means to understand the difference between the impulse and the instinct. We have to act instinctively on many occasions, but we don't want to act impulsively. So which actions to do by default, which actions to do without, with due deliberation, that discernment is what comes by intelligence. So for example, when we see food, at that time, it's a natural bodily reaction that our tongue salivates and our body gets ready for receiving food. Food is necessary for the body. So in that sense, the salivation is an instinctive response. But sometimes, say if I have got diabetes and I see some sweet item. Now, at that time, when my tongue starts salivating, my mind starts craving, that acting on that is undesirable. So that food is itself a necessity, but a particular choice of food may not be necessary. So impulse, when it comes, it pushes us towards certain things. And intelligence means to understand, okay, this, what is the difference? What is coming from the impulse? What is coming from the instinct? And then to choose properly. So again, one could be with respect to the choice of food. Another could also be with respect to quantity of food. Food is necessary, but our impulse, if good food is available, just keep eating. And then that may be unhealthy. So in that case, to be able to discern, that is intelligence. So now, another way. So now, normally we talk about the mind and the intelligence. So we can say, broadly speaking, the mind is the source of the impulses. And the mind often makes us misunderstand things. So if there is one carry home message from this whole retreat, that is this next sentence. Intelligence means to understand how our mind makes us misunderstand. So our mind makes us misunderstand many things. And this misunderstanding which comes, how to spot it and how to avoid it, how to correct it. That is the role of the intelligence. Sometimes, say, some people are trying to learn car driving. And then, in many cars, if you see the accelerator and the brake, is just next to each other. And say, if at a particular point, you come to a red signal and the next people are slowing down. And the trainer next to you says, hey, slow down. And then, instead of pressing the brake, the person presses the accelerator. So, the car moves forward. So, there is an immediate response that is required. But in this case, the immediate response turns out to be wrong. So, the instructor may have given the instruction, slow down. But the instructor may even say, press the brake. But somehow, my foot goes to the accelerator and press the accelerator. So, that may happen because I panic. That may happen because I'm not thinking clearly for whatever reason. So, normally, when we see some danger, we'll press a brake. And anybody who presses the accelerator, say, what are you doing? Press the brake. But actually, the mind does this opposite thing whenever we come close to an object of attachment. We may resolve, I'm not going to do this. But as soon as we come close to that object of attachment, instead of pressing the brake, we press the accelerator. So we move forward towards it. And this is how, in our inner world, the mind makes us act wrongly. So the intelligence means to understand how the mind is making me misunderstand. Just saying, oh, I don't have willpower, I'm so foolish, I'm fallen. All that is okay at one level. But we have to understand how the mind is making us misunderstand. And then we can correct it.